Why driverless cars won't save the world. This won't be a sunny view about driverless cars, by the way. I'm supposedly a professor of intelligent transport systems. This title was given to me because the university thought it would make money. Actually, my cognate area is traffic flow theory and characteristics, which is a subset of transport modeling, and I explain the difference between these two areas now. This is intelligent transport systems, lots of electronics, computer vision, control rooms, electronic engineers, computer science scientists. They design and build all that stuff. That's what I don't do. I was too fast. Anyway, here's what transport modelers do. Here's the really big thing. It's all about the hardest question, predicting the future. You need to be able to predict the future to decide, for example, whether HS2 is worthwhile. How will people use it? How many people will use it? Are these schemes worthwhile? Answers, by the way, spoiler, HS2 isn't worthwhile by any calculation. Oh, now we're on to the next question. What are the real problems in transport? There are two. Congestion, simple as this, it's economics. Demand for travel exceeds supply for mobility. Has always been like that, and every time we increase supply, demand goes up. That's a problem. It's going to get worse. Population's going up. Economies grow. Demand for travel is pretty much synced with the size of your economy. So congestion as a problem ain't going away, and that's a real problem that needs to be solved. I haven't practiced this. Well, there we go. You can have a look at that arrow. Oh, there we go. There's the other problem. In all kinds of ways, mechanized transport's killing us. Here's three, CO2, big, big problem. Particulate and NOx emissions from tailpipes, another big problem. And thirdly, frankly, we need to do a lot more walking and cycling and running and things like that, and cars get in the way. So what exactly are these for? Do they solve any of the two big problems? Just imagine this, you're an enormous corporation. You've got $400 billion in the bank, cash pile, and your business model is being threatened by regulators. I think what you do is try to find something else to invest in. I think that's what's going on at the moment. Here's some buzzwords you have to know. AVs, autonomous vehicles, there isn't a word human vehicle. That would be weird, you see. How can you have a human vehicle? So it's not HV, they're called LVs, legacy vehicles. And the other thing you need to know is buzzwords, SCEE levels of autonomy. Oh, they're out the window already. Claim one, so this is what driverless car people say. AVs will be safer than legacy vehicles. That's a graph of fatalities in the UK. Do you know what? Road safety here in the Western world is not a big policy priority. You could make casualties go down in other ways than making your system autonomous. Are AVs actually all that safe? That's a Tesla with the front end missing. You know, there's only an accident in human driving once every 100 billion miles. And we just don't know whether these things are safe anymore. And in fact, in some test experiments I've been doing on a test track in northern Italy, there's been lots of crashes. Okay, here's a safe system. This is Mobileye RSS, which now belongs to Intel. It's a patented system which keeps safe headways. It's safe in some system boundary. Unfortunately, it only achieves a third of the throughput, that's the traffic flow, that humans achieve. So it's no good. Claim two, just think of all those things you can do while the car's driving by itself in the back seat. You know, working on your computer, maybe more exciting things on the back seat. Really? Have you tried doing that in a car at the moment? You can't. Anyway, so that's a false claim. Claim three, there'll be a smooth way to this world with no steering wheel. Sorry about the slightly grotesque pictures. That's not where Boeing are at the moment. It's been shown that mixing autonomy with human control is a complete disaster. Okay, maybe there's this world where driverless cars will take lots of taxis, will take lots of one-person cars off the road. You'll probably recognise that's David Mellor, the Conservative MP who did some naughty things. Would you get into the taxi with that guy, you know? Not unless there was another figure called a driver regulating the situation. Another claim, AVs will result in more efficient traffic flow. Actually, that's, you'll realise, is the magic roundabout in Swindon. It looks like it's chaotic, but you know what? Humans, via our interaction with our eyes, are remarkably good at maximising traffic flow. Don't think AVs will do better, only marginally so. If you want to make things green, work on electric vehicles. That's got lots of challenges, both in the vehicle technology and network questions about where you put the charging points and all of the economics and engineering that sits under it. And this is the other thing you need to work on. At the end of the day, to solve the problems I started with at the beginning, congestion and emissions, you have to suppress demand for travel, and that's a transport economics modelling question, like I do. You all love that, of course. I love technology. I'm trying not to be completely rude to people in the EE and CS departments who think that computers and tech will save the world. I love all that, but if we're actually trying to solve the real transport problem, in fact, probably AVs are going to do something more like that. That's a convoy of trucks. We can engineer that now. That has a gain. Drivers could do much longer stints because they'd be able to sleep for sections of the motorway. You get more efficient truck flow, you'd save some carbon. And this is ethically, if you say, I honestly don't think researching in AVs is an ethical branch of research unless you have all these caveats I've mentioned. This is what I think we should be trying to do, is actually design our way to a better future. And there's a bit of math here. This is asymmetric double well potential, you realize. And we basically got to work out how to get over the energy hump and engineer our new system. Done.